whether it's in the winter or the summer, colds and flus alike, these tips are ways to fight the nasty germs that we always get exposed to. So curcumin is the active ingredient in turmeric. And we know that turmeric is very similar, it's in the same family as ginger root. So both of them are very anti-inflammatory. So I actually like to eat ginger or drink ginger tea as part of my diet, but I'm not as fond of turmeric, and so I like to take it in capsule form. So why do we need to worry about inflammation when we're trying to get rid of a cold or a flu? Well, inflammation is created anytime our bodies have an infection. So if we have a short-term infection, like a cold or a flu, or if we have a long-term infection, the results are the same. Our body creates inflammation as a way to heal from that infection. So when we have a cold or a flu, we can bump up our dose of curcumin in order to get the inflammation down. So specifically, it will target wherever you have inflammation. That's probably going to be in your throat or in your lymph nodes. If you're already taking curcumin supplements, I hope that you're taking Terry Naturally or another company that uses BCM95. So the BCM95 formulation has been shown over and over again to be better absorbed. So when you're taking the curcumin, you're actually absorbing it and your body's actually using it for fighting inflammation. So I usually take curcumin all year long. But in the winter, or when there's a lot of colds and flus going around, which is sometimes in the summer, I will add in extra turmeric to my supplements. So maybe I take 1,000 milligrams every day for general maintenance, and then during illness times or times when I think that I'll be exposed to more germs, then I will take 2,000 to 3,000 milligrams for a short period of time.